Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel and my art studio. I am Mrs. B, your Catholic art teacher. Boys and girls, today we are going to use our primary colors, all the colors of our color wheel, and you remember what you did last week. We use the primary colors red, yellow, and blue to create our secondary colors of orange, green, and purple. And we made tints using white. We just added white to our primary colors to get a tint, and we added black to two of our yellow and orange. We added black to get this lovely shade, different shade. So today, boys and girls, we are going to create a beautiful picture using warm and cool colors. So we're going to find out what are the warm colors and what are the cool colors. So boys and girls, the first thing I want you to do is draw a line going across your page like that, and on one side we're doing the day, and this is going to be a night scene. So the day scene would be like the sun just rising. So we're going to draw on this side half a circle, so we can just maybe get a something like that and just draw around it like this. So we just do this like that, and we're going to draw lines to indicate the rays of the sun. You can use a ruler if you wish, but I like to go freehand too sometimes, and I think that I'm better control when I am working freehand. So I'm just going to go ahead and draw some lines as straight as I possibly can. You know, you would get some wobbly lines like there, but in any case, I'll do my best to have a straight-ish line. So here we have the sun and the rays of the sun. All right, and you remember what we learned in the first term, different lines. We're going to use some of that in our sun. So we're going to use like zigzag lines, going zigzag, zigzag, like that. And then we're going to use perhaps, let's say, lines that kind of go straight lines like that. We'll double it. So we'll do, and you have that one going like that, and then you have that. Okay, so that's a kind of a pattern. So we're trying to create pattern, boys and girls. All right, and then maybe we'll just do some dots, and as it's going closer to the end, it gets bigger and bigger like that. And then the next one, perhaps we can just draw another zigzag like that, and this time we can just put a little triangles in them like that, and then that one can have triangles like that too. And in this one we can do sort of like a swirly lines like that. And let's do some, this is zigzag, so we're going to do some curvy lines like that. I'm going to do it coming out like that. And then we're going to do it like that, coming out like that. Oh, this is nice. So we're going to do a repeat of those lines again. So we're going to do the zigzag, up, down, up, down. down, up. Then you're going to do the one that goes, you're going to do something going like this. Let's do it that way. And then we're going to just do a line going that way, a line going there. Then go there, a line going down here. And a line going across, a line going up. You know, just random lines, boys and girls, that's okay. You can do the same going like that. You can do another line going like this. You know, just some random lines. And then we're going to draw like a circle. And as it's going, getting bigger and bigger and bigger, like that. And then we're going to do a narrower zigzag, so it goes zigzag, but it's very narrow. The other one is more wider. And then what we're going to do, we're just going to do little triangles at the bottom of this zigzag. And then we just draw lines like that, I suppose. These are just patterns, boys and girls. As you can see, as I'm going along, I'm just creating some nice, lovely designs like that. And then the next one is swirlies, like that. So we're going to go like that, big, and get smaller, big, to get smaller, big, as you get smaller. And then you can just maybe just have something like that to show that it's going to be a beginning of a swirly line. And then we have these are curved lines like this, and then we just double the layer going, and we just do it again, and then yeah, we just keep the top part of like that. And then we just end with a zigzag, which I think is okay. Zigzag like that. Good. So that's our circle. We can actually, what would be good is in the circle, we can maybe just have lines going around it like that. And I'm going to continue with the zigzag going like that. I just love it. Love to see it. It just reminds me of the rays, the sunlight rays, you know, to show that the rays of the hot sun coming out like that. And then we can just maybe just have hearts to show that we love the sun. Can turn it around, you know, like that, and then you can have circles like that, all the same size going in here, and a love heart here. And then, boys and girls, on this side now, we're going to do the moon and the stars in the night. So we're going to have a lovely kind of a shaped moon, like a crescent moon like that, and we're gonna have lovely stars around the crescent moon like that. Okay, like that. And that looks quite fun. And maybe we can do these as well, just to show, because there's all different stars in the night sky, and we can certainly put our own designs and patterns of the night sky, if you will, in your designs. And yeah, so boys and girls, we have lines going straight and around and you've got the night sky. We can have like I don't know, we can just maybe just have curved lines going like this to imitate the crescent. Yeah, we're not going to make it any complicated line like that. Yeah, that should do the ticket. So boys and girls, now that we've got our design showing light and dark, we need to get using our cool colors, which are purple, blue and green. We're going to put it in the night sky, and then so let's do the night sky first, and then we'll do the warm colors for the sun. All right, so let's get started, boys and girls. So the stars is supposed to be yellow, but because we're doing cool colors, we're going to make the stars like a lime green color. So we're going to activate the colors that we have here already. See. And wet it. So then we've got some nice. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this like lime green color for the stars that are here. Actually, that reminds me of this. The lime green reminds me of the 10 stars we have on our Dominican flag. And it's actually lime green, the color, not yellow like some people think. And we're going to add some more green to the, just to give it a different dimension, boys and girls, maybe. Just here, just a little green here like that, just in the middle of this type of, so it will be like a ball of light, which is what the star is, a ball of fire. So we can just do that across. And I think the moon is a gray kind of color, so we're gonna add a lot of water to the moon to have it very light color. Let's use that. So we're going to, is that light enough? I wonder. So we're going to lay it down. We can actually use a tint. So by using some white and blue, we can get a tint of the for the moon, boys and girls. So that's nice. So these are all cool colors, and the night sky is purple, so we're gonna go ahead and paint the rest of this picture in a deep purple color. So we're gonna get the blue, we're gonna put some in there, and then we're going to color the rest of the picture in purple, the rest of this half in purple. So let's just do that now, boys and girls. And just add some water. This is a bottle of just water that I use to spray to, just to activate my colors when I need them. So this is actually, oopsie, the purple night sky. So we're going to use cool colors, purple, we're going to use blue, we're going to use, so we're going to have the blue, we have blue for the moon, but it's a very light blue, so it's okay, we can add a darker shade of blue for the night sky. Alright, so we're going to do this pattern like that. Alright, so we're going to have, it's already green, so I'm not going to add any more green. So it's going to be purple and blue, so let's just do that very lightly around our our stars at night so that we can really get that feeling of night. The night is really there. Okay, so we have, just continue with this all the way until we get to the, until we cover the back section of the project. Like I said, we're doing cool and warm colors. We're doing the night sky. At night time, it's lovely and cool, isn't it? Because the sun has gone away, you know, and so it's the moon that comes out. The moon doesn't have as much warmth as the sun. And so the night sky is quite cold. So we're going to use the cold colors to depict that. You know, I just wanted to say that I saw Nayendi's color wheel, and she showed it to me when we were in Rosary Club. And my goodness, Nayendi, it was so beautiful. I really can see that some of you are really, you know, going heads on in your arts and craft, and I really am proud of you guys. You're doing a wonderful job. And so I hope to see more of your flower power color wheel when we meet up this Friday. So here we're doing our lovely night sky using purple, which we mixed already. We've already mixed from a previous class, so that's all good. So we're just doing that. And then we have another purple right here to end our night scene using cool colors like that. And I like how the green came out really nicely, you know, in the night sky. All right, so we're gonna do blue now. So you wash your paintbrush. Let me add a bit more blue again to this mixture. We're going to add some blue here to make it nice and powerful. Powerful blue. So we're going to just add nice powerful blue to this night sky to create the cool colors that we have been experimenting since we've been back from school. And the moon is actually, we added some white with the blue and plenty of water to create this lovely tint of, it's almost like a silver color, the moon in the night sky. Really wonderful. I'm really enjoying doing the painting sessions with you all. I hope you too are enjoying your sessions, painting and having a good time. So that's it, boys and girls. We're just going to add okay, that's the blue. Oopsie. Let me just take another paintbrush and just swipe that over so that it doesn't get too dark. You know? Okay. And we're going to continue with the blue on the ends of this segment of our demonstration or artwork of warm and cool colors. showing the night sky, which comprises of blue, purple, and green. Okay, so there you have it. Okay, boys and girls, lastly, right here, we're going to put in our final drawing of the night sky to complete that section, and then we're going to go over and do the other side, which is going to be warm color. So we're going to be showing lovely sun, the sun rays. It's going to be wonderful, boys and girls. There you go. So there we have the night sky, and looks really great. And on the other side, we're going to do the sun. So we're going to wash our paintbrush thoroughly, and it's going to be yellow, orange, and red. So I'm going to begin with the heart. Let's just add some red to it, boys and girls. Oops, like that. And we're going to add red to the night sky, like that. Add red like that. And I'm going to go ahead and do red here too for this part of the drawing. I'm going to use red. No, because with the sun, it's a ball of fire, so it's like reds and orange, and you know, those lovely colors like that. So so we have that. I'm gonna add this red as well here, like that. And then we just add red to all these little patterns or designs, you know. So let's just do that very quickly. And I'm going to add red here to this part of it. Trying not to go over the edge, boys and girls. Yeah, and let me just add some red here too. And you know, just improvise, boys and girls. Just be creative in the choices of your colors and where you're going to put them. All right, so and put it on that side of it, I think. Then next we're going to do orange, and then we're going to do yellow. I'm going to mostly have the sun in orange and yellow. So we're going to have like fun, boys and girls. It's going to be great. We're going to mostly have the sun in orange and yellow. Orange and yellow, not red. The red we're going to only use for accents, like different little shapes and patterns, just to highlight the red that is part of the cool colors. But boys and girls, you know already that it's I think I'm going to do this as well in red, like that, because just to spread it out a little bit. Good. So we're going to do the orange next, and then the yellow, and then I'll get back to you. So there you have it, boys and girls, our night and day. Warm and cool colors. So boys and girls, what we're going to do, just to accentuate the design, we're going to Use a coloured pencil in black or your own pencil. Make sure that the point is sharpened, so you sharpen the end so it's pretty sharp like this. Alright, and then we're going to make sure that your paint is completely dry before you do this, because you will make a mess. Let's just move that to the side like that. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to draw a line just to accentuate the lines that's been covered with the paint. I'm just going to draw a black line going all the way across that's dividing the page from cool colors and warm colors. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to draw a line around the crescent moon like that, and then you're going to do that again. And then, boys and girls, after you've done that, you're going to draw a line over the waves that we've done in the night sky of purple and blue. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to do, I think we're going to go over the stars as well. What do you think, boys and girls? I think that would be quite helpful to emphasize the design. So we're going to go ahead and draw over our lines very carefully. I'm going to do the same thing here, like that. Yeah. Okay, and then we're going to go over the stars, like that. Over the stars. Like that. Do, and then we finish doing the cool colors and the night sky, which is okay. Okay. And then we're going to do one more here. That's it done. Then we're going to go here and do the warm colors, so daytime. Yeah. Then you have to keep sharpening your pencils because you need to have it pretty sharp. All right. So let's continue. And then I'm just going to go over these patterns, boys and girls, very quickly. And then you're going to do the raise. Let me just draw the lines first. Okay, and let's just continue drawing the lines. I'm going to continue this till the end and then I'll get back to you boys. So boys and girls, I have outlined the night sky and the sun, and boys and girls, I've even added some glitter because you know the song Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how I wonder what you are, up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. And then the sun is bright and beautiful as it glimmers on the sea. You can see the actual sparkles of the sun. So boys and girls, this is it. This is the end of this project. And I'd love to see your work, boys and girls. So get cracking and you'll show me your lovely created work, and I'll see you in the next video. God bless you. Bye.